Today we will discuss about non-inverting amplifier and inverting amplifier of the op-amp. This is the previous question I will discuss, and model question also I will discuss. So before discussing this question, first I will discuss what is op-amp. This is called operational amplifier. Operational amplifier, you know, it increases the strength of the signal. Operational amplifier means, why it is called operational amplifier? Because this amplifier is used to perform the mathematical operation. So, mathematical operation means what? Addition, subtraction, and multiplication and integration and differentiation. So these are the mathematical operations that can be performed by the op-amp. First is addition, subtraction, multiplication and integration and differentiation. So it is called operational amplifier because it can be used as a mathematical operator to perform the mathematical operation. Okay, this is the introduction of the op-amp. So first I will discuss about the non-inverting amplifier and inverting amplifier. Non-inverting amplifier and this is inverting amplifier. So first I will draw the circuit diagram. This is R1. This is op-amp circuit, negative, positive. This is the feedback resistor. This is 0, V1 voltage is applied, this is ground. We know this voltage is equal to this voltage. Whatever, suppose this voltage is V negative, this voltage is V positive. If this op-amp is ideal, ideal means what? The gain of the op-amp may be tends to infinity. So V voltage at the non-inverting point is equal to the voltage at the inverting point, because I know V0 equal to, in class I have discussed, V0 equal to AV into V positive minus V negative, which is nothing but differential voltage Vd. So V positive minus V negative equal to V0 by AV. If AV tends to infinity, then V positive minus V negative equal to V0 by infinity is nothing but 0. Because something divided by infinity is 0. So V positive equal to V negative. It's the concept. First, you should know this voltage is should be equal to this voltage. Okay. Then we'll take the forward. Then next, what we'll do, step one. First, if this voltage is this voltage, so V negative. So V negative is equal to V positive is equal to 0 volt. Okay. Then applying KCL. Applying KCL at inverting point, or I can name it, this is node 1. KCL means what? Kirchhoff's current law. That is what? Sum of the entering current is equal to sum of the leaving current. So whatever the current is entering into this direction, it is bifurcated into this direction. Suppose I1 current is flowing is equal to this IF current, feedback current, plus IX current. IX means it is going into OPA. Okay. But IX is zero for ideal OPA. Ideal OPA Rin is infinity. So I1 current equal to IF current. So whatever the current is flowing from the source, that is flowing through the feedback resistor. This is resistor. So I1 equal to IF. How will I1 be? So I1 equal to V1 minus V negative, V1 minus V negative divided by R1 is nothing but is equal to 0 minus V0 by Rf. Okay? Then V1 minus 0 equal to R1 equal to 0 minus V0 by Rf. Okay? Implies V0 by V1 equal to minus Rf by R1. Okay, V0 equal to V0 by V1 is equal to minus Rf by R1. It is nothing but the voltage gain. Voltage gain. The ratio of voltage gain definition, Rp equal to V0 by V1 means the ratio of output voltage to input voltage. So this is the voltage gain of non-inverting amplifier. Why it is called inverting? Why it is called inverting? This is the gain of the inverting amplifier. Second, I will discuss the non-inverting amplifier. Why it is called non-inverting, why it is called inverting, I will explain later. First I will explain the voltage gain. Similarly, this is R1, negative, positive. This is Rf. This is V0. Okay, this is 0. Ground, 0 volt. Suppose voltage is applied. This is V1. Okay. This is the non-inverting circuit. Non-inverting circuit. So non-inverting circuit, this point is equal to this voltage. So V positive equal to V negative, I derived in the previous. So V positive is nothing but V1. Okay. Similarly, applying the KCL, applying KCL at node 1, node 1, so it is called node 1. So KCL means what? The Kirchhoff's current law. But I told sum of the entering current equal to sum of the leaving current. So this is entering, this is leaving. So suppose this is IF, this is I1, same, this is IX. I1 equal to IF plus IX. But IX is 0 because I am in infinity. Ideal op amp IX is 0. So I1 equal to IF is nothing but 0 minus V1. This is I1 means what? This potential minus this potential divided by resistance. That is current. 0 minus V1 by R1 is nothing but IF is what? This potential minus this potential divided nuclear resistor RF, because current is flowing from this point to this point. So V1 minus V0 divided by RF, which nothing into I thought, minus V1 by R1 is V1 minus V0 by RF. Okay? Imply that V1 minus V0 equal to minus RF by R1 into V1. It will multiply with this. So V0 equal to V1 plus RF by R1 into V1, because it will come into this side, it will come into this side, negative will go that side, means it will positive, and this negative will come into this side, means positive. So V0 by V1 equal to 1 plus RF by R1. It is the voltage gain of non-inverting amplifier. So I can write V0 by V1 equal to 1 plus RF by R1. This is the voltage gain. This is voltage gain of non-inverting amplifier. So we derive these things. First, inverting amplifier I derive. Second, non-inverting amplifier I derive. So I will explain why it is called non-inverting, why it is called inverting. The derivation. From this derivation, first inverting, non-inverting. Okay. Inverting means what? V0 by V1, from the derivation you can write minus RF by R1, V0 by V1 equal to 1 plus RF by R1. So V1 is nothing but input voltage. This is nothing but output voltage. Okay. So 1 plus RF, why it is called inverting? Because see here, this is a constant value. RF by R1, RF is a value, resistance value, R1, RF the feedback resistance. It may be value of 10 ohm or it may be 5 ohm. Similarly, R1 also 2 ohm, 5 ohm, like that. So it is a constant. So V0 equal to negative minus K into V1. So why inverting? Why it is called inverting? That is the important point. Because suppose V1 signal I am applying. Suppose one sinusoidal signal I am applying. Suppose V1 equal to A sin omega t. Okay. This is A sin omega t. Okay. And it will multiply with the constant with negative. It will be inverted. Negative means what? The phase shift will be phase shift 180 degrees. Suppose 1 is there, minus 1 you are getting. What is the difference between 1 and minus 1? 1 and minus 1, one difference, similarity is the magnitude is the same. Magnitude may be same, magnitude is same, but phase here 0 degree, here 180 degree. In complex number you know 1 and minus 1, if we will plot 1 this, minus 1 this. So 180 degree phase shift. So whatever the signal you will apply at the input of the op amp, that will be inverted in the inverting amplifier. That is the concept. So why we are saying that it is an inverting amplifier, because whatever the voltage we are applying, it is inverted at the output. So V0 is the inverted version of the input voltage. It may be multiplied with the constant, but the phase shift is 180 degree. That is the main point. So it is called inverting amplifier. Non-inverting amplifier, you know, there is no negative term. Then whatever the voltage we are applying, whatever the signal we are applying, the same phase shift. There is no phase shift between the input and output, because it is a constant. So the phase shift is suppose A sin omega t. I am applying A sin omega t. Then here this is a constant, so k into A sin omega t. But here minus k into A, this minus will introduce the 180 degree phase shift, so it is not inverting, this is the non-inverting amplifier. Minus 1 over 1, you know, magnitude is same, 180 degree phase shift. So if cos omega t, you will apply cos omega t, sin omega t, graphically I can, graphically, suppose it is graph A sin omega t. This is the V1. Output, it will invert it. It will invert it. The amplification, Oppa will do the amplification. That will multiply. This is the K. This is the amplification factor. But phase shift, phase negative will introduce to 180 degree phase shift in the Oppa. This in the output. That is the difference between inverting and non-inverting amplifier. Here there is no phase shift. Here the 180 degree phase shift. So it is the question, it may come into the semester. Next question we will discuss. Integrator and differentiator. Because OPAM, I told that OPAM can be used as a mathematical operation. So first mathematical operation, suppose it is an integrator. Okay, here exam question can become, why it is called OPAM, and explain any two mathematical operation or application of the OPAM. So first can explain the integrator circuit. So integrator circuit, if will come into the exam, then you will draw the integrator circuit. First, A0, A1, A0. Suppose this is R1, this is C1. Okay. Similarly, this current is equal to this current plus this current. It is nothing but just network theories. KCL you will apply, that you can solve. So applying KCL, same procedure, applying KCL at node 1. So this is node 1. Okay. So V1 minus 0. Because R1 is nothing but 0 minus V0 by 1 by SC. 1 by SC means the Laplace transform. In mathematics you know the resistance R, Laplace will be R, L, inductance will be SL, C, 1 by CS. Okay. Then V1 by R1 equal to minus SC V0. So V0 equal to minus V1 by R1 into SC. I can write minus V1 by S into RC. Okay. But in Laplace transform, one property is there, that is integration properties. Suppose X of T is a signal. In mathematics, you know, X of T is a signal. So Laplace transform will be X of S. In S domain, Laplace transform will calculate in the S domain. In mathematics you know. I can prove it, how it converted to X of T to X of S. But in mathematics you will know. X of T will, suppose integration of X of T into dt will be X of S divided by S. This is the integration of the signal with the time domain. That will result X of S. This is the Laplace transform properties. So, B0 is nothing but माइनस वन बाई अस्सी अस्सी इंटू वी वन बाई एस अप्लाई सो सिमिलर टाइम लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म विल कन्वर्ट फ्रॉम टाइम डोमेन टू एस डोमेन सो इनवर्स लाप्लास विल कन्वर्ट फ्रॉम एस डोमेन टू टाइम डोमेन दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट सो इफ लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म एक्स ऑफ टी लाप्लास ट्रांसफॉर्म विल बी एक्स ऑफ एस then x of s will convert inverse Laplace transform this is inverse Laplace transform so it is in the Laplace form because in the L domain so apply ILT inverse Laplace transform suppose this is equation 1 in equation 1 so directly you can write v0 of t time domain is minus 1 by r1 c1 integration of bit into dt it is the signal it is the output of the integration integrator it is the output of the integrator so what you observe why it is called integration integrator because it performs the integration so op amp the mathematical operation is integrator so mathematical integration so it can be used as integrator what you observe observation what will write you will write we observe from the derivation of the integrator the input signal this is input this is output output is observe you observe that output is integration of the input or input is integrated and you got output it is the integration of the input so it is called integrator that is the mathematical operation of integrator integration performed by op amp is called integrator so input is integrated with this circuit and output is the integration of input VIFT so it is called integrator RC is what it is a time constant suppose VIFT you are applying a sin omega t you will integrate sin omega t integration of sin t if you will apply the cos t integration of the cos t you will find that signal so it is an integration this is the one mathematical operation second mathematical operation second mathematical operation suppose op amp is used as a differentiator differentiator so this is a mathematical operation I'm drawing the circuit first suppose V naught this is V input okay so this is okay. So this is C1 this is R1 okay so this voltage is equal to this voltage because I explained first V0 equal to V into V positive minus V negative so V positive minus V negative equal to V0 by V if ideal op amp V tends to infinity something divided by infinity is zero is implied that V positive equal to V negative So at the voltage at the inverting point is equal to the non-inverting point. So here is zero means here is also zero. So applying the KCL, same. Op amp is very easy. Applying KCL and mark fetching in exam, you will attend the op amp question. Easily you can derive, easily you can explain, and easily you can get the mark. It is mathematics. So easily you can score the mark. Easily you can attend. Easily you can get the mark. Applying KCL, and node 1. I am explaining nothing. It is all network theory, basic electrical concept, KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. Thing I am explaining. No more concept. Only mathematical equation. So behind the mathematical equation, you should know the concept. Why? What is OPAM? Why it is operational amplifier? What is the mathematical operation? You should know that. Applying KCL at node 1. Okay? So if it is in Laplace, C1 is converted to C1S, VIS, V0 of S, R1 will be similar to R1. Because R1 is a memoryless element, C1 and CL, inductor and capacitor, those are the memory element. Suppose VI of S minus 0 by 1 by SC1 is nothing but 0 minus V0 S by R1 is nothing but V1 into SC1 is nothing but minus V0 S by R1 V1 of S. So minus R1 S C1 into VI of S is nothing but V0 of S. Minus will come into this side and this R1 is multiplied with this side. So V0 of S equal to minus S into V1 of S, this is input, whole multiplied with RC. Or you can see minus R1C1 into S into VI of S. It is the expression of differentiator. But how you will prove that it is a differentiator? Because previous I explained that is integrator, it is differentiator. In Laplace, x of t is in Laplace transform of x of s, integration with time x of t of x of s, this is the integration property. Similarly, dy dt of x of t is nothing but x of s. It is the time differentiation property of Laplace transform. Time differentiation property of Laplace transform. The time integration integrated with time, integrated with, differentiated with time. So time differentiation property of the Laplace transform. So dy d of t x of t s of x, that is Laplace transform. If we apply the inverse Laplace ILT, then we will find this property. Similarly, what is the expression? This is the expression. So suppose this is equation 1. Applying inverse Laplace transform in equation 1, V0 of t equal to minus RC into dvi t by dt. Okay, it is the expression of the differentiator side. It is the time constant RC, but the D indicates that the differentiation. Integration signal will integrator. So output is the differentiation of input. Whatever the signal you will apply at the input of the op-amp, in a differentiator circuit, you will get the output, that is the differentiation of the input. So it is called differentiator. It is a mathematical operation. So minus RC dvc by dt. In higher class, we will read the integrator behaves as a low pass filter and the differentiator behaves as a high pass filter. In higher class, we will study how the integrator behaves as a, that is the application, integrator behaves as a low pass filter and a different. So it is the mathematical operation addition. And previously I told that op amp can be used as a mathematical operator that performs the mathematical operation. That is, addition means adder or summing circuit. So op amp will design the adder. So suppose this is R1 and designing the circuit. Suppose voltage V1 I am applying. Similarly, R2, this is V2. Similarly, R3. This is feedback resistor RF. This is VGO. So this is a this is voltage V3. V1, V2, V3. I am applying at the inverting point of the op amp. This is R1, this is R2, and this is R3. So this is a feedback resistor, this is output. So I will prove that the circuit is adder or it is a summing circuit. How will you prove that? Previously I proved that circuit is the integrator performs integration. The circuit is a differentiator perform differentiation. That is the two mathematical operation, and the third mathematical operation is the addition. Previously I explained inverting circuit and non-inverting circuit. So simply same method applying KCL A node 1. Okay, applying KCL at node 1. So this current, suppose I1, this current, suppose I2, this current, I3. So I1 plus I2 plus I3 is nothing but Ix plus If. What is If? This is If, this is Ix. This circuit I am explaining Ix is 0, so no need to explain. So I1 plus I2 plus I3 equal to If. So applying KCL means what? Sum of the entering current is equal to the sum of leaving current. Whatever the current is entering, that is leaving. That is the KCL. I am explaining only network theory. There is no need I am explaining. This is only nothing I am explaining, only mathematics. Only the basic electrical, and you are studying the analog electronic circuit. So it is the correlate. If you don't know the network theory or basic electrical, then you don't know the analog electronic circuit. Analog electronic circuit is the combination of network theory and the semiconductor physics. You should know the concept of semiconductor physics and the mathematical derivation equation. You will find out the, you will learn from the network theory. We will superimpose the pure semiconductor physics and network theory, we will get the analog electronics. So V1 equal to, I can write V1 minus 0 by R1, because this voltage is 0. Why? I know V0 equal to V into V positive minus V negative. So V positive minus V negative equal to V0 by infinity is 0. V positive equal to V negative. So R1 plus I1 plus I2. V2 minus 0 by R2 plus V3 minus 0 by R3 is nothing but 0 minus V0 divided by R. Okay? So I can write this equation in this part. So V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3 is nothing but minus V0 by R8. So I can write V0 equal to minus RF into V1 plus R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3. Is it the expression for adder circuit?
इक्वेशन नंबर
ओके दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ फैडर सर्किट इट परफॉर्म्स द एडिशन व्हिच इज द अनदर टाइप ऑफ मैथमेटिकल ऑपरेशन सो इफ सपोज इफ यदि आर वन इक्वल टू आर टू इक्वल टू आर थ्री इक्वल टू आर देन आई कैन राइट वी जीरो इक्वल टू माइनस आर एफ बाई आर इंटू वी वन प्लस वी टू प्लस वी थ्री इट इज द अनदर मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन ओके दैट मीन्स दिस विल R1 will become R. This is R. This is R. It will become now. So this is the mathematical expression. What you observe from this mathematical equation? That is the important. What you observe? Observation is very important. And you should know that. What is the reason behind the mathematical equation? Whatever the equation you are writing in your paper, you should know why I am writing. So V0 equal to minus Rf by R, V1 plus what it observed. So I can write. This is observation. Observation. Output is sum of 3 input signal. Why? Because RF is one value, it may be 10 ohm, 1 kilo ohm, 500 ohm, similarly, so it is a constant. So V0 equal to minus K of V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay. So output is sum of input signal. It is addition of 3. Output is the addition of 3 input. V1, V2, V3. So output is addition of V1 plus V2 plus V3. So it is called adder. Because output is the addition of 3 signal. Negative is because it is a non-inverting amplifier, because the voltage is applying at the inverting point, negative point, input voltage. So the negative is coming. But concept is that observation is that V0 is V1 plus V2 plus V3. Output is the addition of 3 input signal. That is the addition from adder. Adder performs addition. Addition is the mathematical operation. Operator is the adder. So, introduction I told that operational amplifier. Amplification is happening because this is the amplification factor. Whatever the signal you are applying at the input, amplification means what? It increases the strength of the signal. It increases the amplitude of the signal. It increases the strength of the signal. That is op amp. So introduction, what I told about the op amp, that I proved in the different circuit. That is inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier, integrator circuit, differentiator circuit, and adder circuit. So summary, what I told. So summary. Okay. Summary is that, first I explain OPA. This is the latch device. What I explained, I am taking OPA. Revise is very important. Revision is very important. What you studied or what I explained, you should revise. OPA. First I have OPA. Amplification plus operation. Okay, this is the summary. One addition, second integration, third differentiation. Okay, differentiation. These are the mathematical operations. So, op-amp operational amplifier means it can be used as a mathematical operation
that is addition integration differentiation, mathematical adds integrator and differentiator.
Amplifier means it will amplify the increases the strength of the signal that is op amp.
So second I explain inverting and the non-inverting.
Whatever the signal you will apply in the inverting circuit, the output will be phase shift, 180 degree phase shift.
Because V0 equal to minus RF by R1 into V1.
So negative point indicates that whatever the signal, input signal you are applying, you will get the 180 degree phase shift. Suppose you are applying, this is a cosine signal, you will get, okay, inverted, phase shift, this.
So 180 degree phase shift, inverting amplifier, 180 degree phase shift. And I in a complex number of minus 1 and 1 also, magnitude itself the angle is different. Okay.
So 1 plus A0, minus 1 plus A0, so minus plus, plus plus, with the first quadrant, it is the second quadrant. So 180 degree phase shift. So non-inverting amplifier V0 equal to 1 plus RF by R1 into V1. So it is a non-inverting amplifier. Amplified 1 plus, this is the amplification factor. But 0 degree phase shift. Here you observe 0 degree phase shift, there is no negative term. So that is the non-inverting amplifier. Non-inverting, inverting. You should analyze the concept. Non-inverting what? Non-inverting, inverting. Inverting means inverted. In digital circuit, you know this is the digital inverter, 1 0 0 1, inverted, whatever the complement, what is you are applying, that is inverted. So non-inverting amplifier and inverting amplifier. Last I explain integrator and the differentiator. So integrator and differentiator. So V0 equal to minus 1 by RC integration of VI of t into dt. So V0 equal to minus RC into dvt by VI of t into dt. So integration means what? The output is the integration of input. This is the input signal, time differentiation, time integration property, and the Laplace transform. That is the integrator and differentiator. V0 equal to minus RC dv by dt. D indicates that it is the differentiation. And I explained low pass filter we have said integrator, and high pass filter is a, we have said different meaning. Higher class you will read that concept. Integrator, differentiator. Last time you told you adder. Addition. That's it, that is summing circuit. Okay, summing circuit. So output I got V0 into minus K, V1 plus V2 plus V3. Whatever the signal you are applying, three signal you apply, V1, V2, V3. Output is summation of input. That is V1, V2 and V3. Okay. Suppose n type of signal, it is a, here three input signal you are applying at the op amp. If n signal you are applying, so V0 equal to minus K into V1 plus V2 plus V3 dot 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 plus V0. So minus K, summation of I equal to 1 to n V1. The summation indicates the summing circuit. That is the summation, summing. The op amp can be used as a summation, the summing circuit. Addition. So it is the input of the sum of the input signal, V1, V2, V3. That is the concept. That is the mathematical equation. And one question need memory came into the exam, Ideal op-amp. What is the ideal op-amp?
ideal means it is not physically realizable. Physically it is not possible. Theoretically you can say, but practically this form is not possible because it is again infinity. So characteristics of the dopamine coming to the exam. This question, first will write the voltage gain tends to infinity. Second, resistance, RE, input resistance tends to infinity. Third, R0 tends to 0. It is the characteristics of the ideal opam, that is not physically realizable, not practically possible. No, in laboratory you cannot design. That is the ideal opam. Theoretically, V tends to infinity and V positive equal to V negative. This is the very important point. V negative is the voltage at the non-inverting point. Voltage at the non-inverting point is equal to the voltage at the inverting point. That is the opam. This is the ideal opam characteristics. CMRR infinity. So, characteristics of ideal opam. One question. They asked me in the ISRO interview regarding opam, can you tell me application of the opam in open loop configuration? What I explained in the class, that is the closed loop, because circuit, whatever I told, feedback resistor V0, this is R1, this is V1, it is a closed loop configuration. Can you tell that application of dopamine open loop configuration? This is question is asked in my student. So, comparator will see in the syllabus. At last, they have written comparator. Comparison between two signals. You are applying one signal at an inverting point, you are applying a signal at a non inverting point. Non-inverting you are applying and inverting you are applying. Compare the circuit. It is open configuration. This question is very important. The interval question. Comparator. Open loop configuration. So it will compare between two signal, two input signal, and it will give the output. That is the comparator. It is the open loop configuration. So I explain opam. Next class I will explain different topic or another topic. So it is the end of the lecture. Okay? Thanks.